And I was sleeping.
I couldn't pay the money back when I told them I would. That's rough. How people look at you, how they respond to you. It's very hard. Here's what I discovered that happens to you in life, that you will go through things, and while you're going through them, you can't understand why it's happening to you. But after you go through it, you get back and you look at it and you say, oh, now I understand why I needed that lesson. Then I saw that that was preparing me for bigger and better things. See, most people want it easy. See, easy come, easy what? Easy go. Learning those things that you don't like to do. But you know that in order for you to get where you want to go, this is one of the hoops that you have to flip through. And I'm saying to you, whatever you got to do, do it, because if you don't, life is going to whoop you until you surrender. How do you hang in there during the hard, difficult times? Les, you must have faith. You've got to believe in yourself. You've got to believe in your abilities. You've got to believe in your service, your company, your ideas, unquestionably. You've got to have faith, and that faith gives you patience. That it's not going to happen as quickly as you want it to happen. A lot of things are going to happen that will catch you off guard. And so therefore, you've got to deal with and handle it as it comes. And not only that, but that faith and patience drives you into action. You got to keep moving.
By continuing to push forward, by continuing to run toward my dream, that one day I would have my own talk show. It's a long shot, ladies and gentlemen, from Liberty City, an abandoned building on a floor, never knowing my mother or father. It's a long shot being here with you today in this dome. In Atlanta, it's a long shot. My mother used to say, birds of a feather flock together. If you run around with losers, you will end up a loser. It's necessary that you get the losers out of your life if you want to live your dream.
Ask yourself the question, the people in my life right now, are they contributing to my growth and development? Are they making me a better person? Is it making me stretch mentally and emotionally and spiritually? Is it getting the best out of me? See, this is the only life you've got.
That you get the energy drainers out of your life. People who don't want anything. People who are not striving. People who are not challenging themselves. People who aren't growing. People who have stopped dreaming. It's necessary that you align yourself with people and attract people into your business who are hungry. People who are unstoppable and unreasonable. People who are refusing to leave life just as it is and who want more.
See, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't use your talents, if you don't use this power, this force that you have within you, you're going to lose it. I travel a lot speaking around the country, and I was out of Detroit for around 2 months. I came back to the airport, went in the parking lot, put my key in the ignition, turned the key. Can anybody tell me what happened? Can you tell me why the car did not get started? The battery was dead. Why was it dead? I had not been using it. Repeat after me, please. If you don't use it, you lose it. If you have the ability to play an instrument, the world's greatest said that if I miss a week of practice, I know it. And if I miss 2 weeks, the critics know it. And if I miss 3 weeks, my audience knows it. If you have the ability to draw well, and if you don't use that talent eventually, you're going to lose it. If I don't speak often, and I one time at one point in my life, I missed speaking for around 6 months. And when I came up before an audience, I was rusty. I could not get my thoughts together. I could not have the power, the kind of confidence that I needed in order to make it happen. So whatever you want to do, whatever idea that you have, the longer that you're sitting on that idea, you are either creating or you are disintegrating. If you're not using it, your skills are diminishing every day. I was on a television program the other day. A lady called in and she said, there's something I like to ask you. And I said, what is it? She said, well, I have this thing I want to do, but I've been unemployed. I lost my job for 2 years. I haven't been able to find a job. I don't have the money and I don't have the contacts and I really don't know what to do. I said, excuse me. I said, the fact that you don't have the money or the contacts really is not the issue. I said, what's the real issue? She said, what do you mean? I said, what's stopping you from doing what you want to do? She said, well, I don't know. I said, but if you did know, what would your answer be? She said, well, I think maybe I'm afraid. I said, what are you afraid of? Maybe I might fail. See, a lot of people allow fear to stop them from living their dream. Answer your calling. Whatever you're called to do, don't count yourself out. Don't say, I can't do that.
You're bombarded with negative stuff every day that beats you down, and you will find yourself unconsciously engaged in self-destructive behavior. If you don't program yourself, life will program you. It's got to be your passion. You got to love it, ladies and gentlemen. You got to love it. It's got to be what you are supposed to do. You want to sing, and even though they want to invite you to Carnegie Hall, you're going to sing to anybody that listens to you, including singing to yourself. I used to talk to my plants when nobody else would listen to me. You're supposed to build something. You're supposed to create something. I don't know how to do it. Learn. Do whatever is required. Just go out there. It's possible you can get what you want. It's necessary. If you want it, you got to go into action. You got to be willing to experiment. You got to be willing to fail and to succeed. You got to be willing to form and to develop new relationships. It's you, it's on you. You got to make that happen. Nobody's going to bring it to you on a silver platter and say, here's your dream manifested. No, it's hard. Yes, it's hard. It's difficult. Yes, right. And it's worth it. It's difficult. It is challenging for kids right now. And it's going to take some easy, simple methods to help bring them out of this madness. Let's look at where we want to go. What is it that we want to produce? What is it that we want to create for our young people? What kind of world are they going to be in? And as we think about that, as we begin to use our collective will and genius and resources, it's possible that we can create an educational system that not only will test their minds with information and facts and figures, but will teach them how to think and be creative and what does it mean to be a human being and to value human life and how do you make relationships work? How do you bounce back from adversity? It's possible that we can give them a curriculum that will give their lives a sense of purpose and direction and meaning and teach them how to begin to know and operate on a higher level of being where they become assets to our society rather than liabilities. What if we leave here with that kind of consciousness that it's possible as opposed to saying we have to write this generation off, that it's possible that we were born for such a time as this and that, that maybe someone here has the idea or the method or some plan of action or an approach that can resolve many of the problems that we're facing with young people today. Whatever we have to do to save our children, it's worth it. So that brings me to the final step, that it's necessary for us to begin to look at the future and know that it's possible that we can have our dream. Yes, it is. Other people have done it. Then we can do it. We fail a lot of times. Well, a lot of other folks fail, and eventually they came back and they succeeded. So it's possible we can have what we want. And we know that we want to get it. It's necessary that we align ourselves with people that think like we do. It's necessary we get negative, do-nothing people out of our lives. It's necessary we never stop learning and growing and developing ourselves. It's necessary that we never give up. We know that it's you, it's me. It's being responsible for our stuff and deciding that we're going to keep on keeping on, that we're going to find a way to win or find a way to make it happen. And we know it's hard. It's not going to be a picnic. And we've all had experiences where we were working on something and we knew it was possible. And we did those things that were necessary to bring it into reality. We took the responsibility to make it happen. Other people couldn't see it. A lot of people didn't believe it. You were attacked. You were criticized. People were opposing you, but you kept on doing it. It was hard. It was rough. It was difficult. But to you, it was worth it. And eventually you got to a level, you know, can nothing stop me now. I'm on the move.
Don't stop running towards your dreams.